So good afternoon, one and all, gathering for this grand occasion for the workshop on queuing model in networking. So on behalf of the vice chairman EV Kumaran sir, and as well as on behalf of our respected registered and our dynamic principal Dr. Ravichandran sir, on behalf of all of this, I've been welcoming our young dynamic who has been done his all the research works in a fantastic manner. So on behalf of the computer science of faculties as well as students, I welcome Dr. S. Harikaran sir, an assistant professor DG Vaishnav Arts and Science College from Chennai. And there is a brief about the professor Dr. S. Harikaran sir has completed his PG courses in Madurai Kamaraj University, and he's done his PhD in the name of applied mathematics in the Florida Institute of Technology in United States of America. And he is having a 10 years of experience in the Department of Mathematics. So on behalf of the department, as well as I make my personal thanks to Professor I.M. Belezer, who has given an opportunity to find an eminent person in the field of mathematics, especially to identify the queuing model networking. So I'm thanks to Dr. I.M. Belezer to give an opportunity to meet this eminent person. So thank you, I.M. Belezer, and also thanks to another Max professor, Mr. Venkatesan sir, to be the part of this particular team. So welcome you, sir, Dr. S. Harikaran sir, to be for this grand occasion on behalf of the institution as well as for the computer science department. So I request our principal to facilitate the gathering. Please, sir.
Good afternoon, one and all present here.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, am I audible? Yeah. It's my pleasure to be part of this eminent workshop on networking, queuing systems in networking, queuing modeling in networking. So we have invited the very valuable chief guest, Dr. Harikaran from DG Vaishnav Arts and Science College, Arumbakkam, Chennai. So why people have to study on networking in their computer science graduation course, and why there is much importance to study some mathematical ability, mathematical knowledge, science, how to integrate it with networking. So there is a lot of scope in networking solutions in the days coming. We hear about Internet of Things, we hear about networking support, networking, network security, and a lot of things. So the area is expanding, wide expanding day by day. So one needs to have to update his skills, and at the same time one needs to have some mathematical background, how to make it more and more perfect in this field. So we have studied in some 20 years ago, networking means we know only LAN, WAN. Today there are a lot many things out there. The car is integrated to the mobile, television is integrated to the mobile, and lot many things, and all the households of things, all the household appliances are linked to one another. It is needed time to have excellent networking skills, and also to have some mathematical background. Being engineers, you must have. So in this scenario background, I want to emphasize the importance of networking studies, and also I request the students to have some networking certification programs during their undergraduation itself. They have a handful of certificates so that it will be useful for getting you, fetching you suitable job. I heard recently from Australia, the average pay paid to any professional is the highest for a networking engineer. It comes about some $80,000 per year in Australia. Then think about what will be the scenario in Europe and America. So I wish all the students to have a very valuable time with Dr. Harikaran today. I thank Dr. Jyotish for arranging this program. Also thanks to Dr. I.M. Bilai and Mr. Venkatesan of Mathematics Department. So hope you have a good day. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable talk, and as well as the informative that you given related to how networks is important and what the pay that the networks peoples are getting over it. So I think this is informative, right informative at the right time, I think. So. Thank you, sir. So I take this opportunity to give a session to Dr. S. Harigiran, sir, to take a topic on queuing model in networking. Please, sir.
Yeah, thank you so much. Am I audible?
Yes, it is audible.
Is my screen visible? My presentation visible?
I don't think so, sir.
Wait a second.
Yeah.
Let me share the screen now. You can verify that. So is my screen visible now? So can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Shall I proceed?
Yes, sir. You can proceed, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. First of all, I would like to thank the Department of Computer Science, Aruna Engineering College, for giving me an opportunity to talk about the application of queuing models. And I personally thank Dr. I.M. Billai for making this happen, and also the management for spending giving an opportunity to students to know about something on a queuing model. So, to be honest, I will just to start with something on the natural scenario where we go for the queuing model, and we'll try to understand the terminologies what we see in queues. Then finally, I try to connect those terminologies terms of mathematics. That is my idea for today's talk. As Principal Sir correctly mentioned, that in networking, the queuing model is useful in the sense that we will have a server and we will have host. So what we do is, we do actually in during my time at IIT Delhi, I was doing programming in this supercomputer called Param Computers. There what we do is, we will submit our job. Whenever we complete our task, we submit the job for running. What it does is, it actually keep my job in queue, and it runs all the jobs whoever submitted to that computer, then it gives back you the result. If you look at it, it's exactly like they are using the queuing model to arrange the job, job order. Then it processes the job. Basically, job means, I mean here is SE programming. So parallel computation, when I do, it was like I can't do it with one system. So I have to submit my program to that server. Server does the job and they give back the result. This is the practical implementation of queuing model. So whoever submits the job, it takes it in order, then automatically it runs the program and gives back the answer. Now if I take this scenario into a banking system, hope you would have visited to banks at least once in your lifetime so far. So when you get into the bank, there will be a teller for distributing the money. What he does actually, he serves the customers one by one. Now if you look at the process, there will be a queue there, you have to join, then you will be, the teller will process the amount one by one and give the amount. So it takes some time actually. More or less, if you observe the job of the teller, he takes exactly or approximately 1 or 2 minutes for each and every customer. Which means what? The teller's job is a uniform interval kind of stuff. So every 2 minutes he serves one customer. But if you look at the bank queue, during the morning session, like the moment they open the bank, it will be like very few customers will be there, and over a period of time, the length of the queue will increase. Then during the lunch time, you can see that it will be getting reduced after that. So it's a natural process in a banking system where we can study the queuing model easily. And in networking or in the banking system or wherever we see that there is a customer as well as there is a service provider, like even car mechanic, when you go, if he has number of cars to be serviced, that is also a queuing model. And when we go to the restaurant, if it is like a self-serve model, so we go to the billing person and be on the queue and get the job done, then go and get the food, again the same queuing model applied there. Now when we see all this, we may think that okay, these are all natural processes, and why do we need to go for a mathematical modeling for the natural processes? Like even the printer model, when we give the jobs by sequence, automatically it takes the job one by one, it prints out, and we get the corresponding printouts. So why do we need a modeling for this? And what is the necessity of looking for the mathematical aspects of all these things? Because whatever situation I have considered so far, they are all very natural. We may think that there is nothing to study or nothing to provide extra information on this. All are happening naturally. Then why I have to spend some time to go for modeling this? Well, we know that the world is growing in terms of technology, and every person wants to improve his business or improve the capacity of the server, or we can say that improve the quality. So everywhere we are thinking of improving certain things. Even the banking system, what we have 20 years back or 10 years back, it was not at all there. Now when you visit a bank, you don't you see rarely a customer standing over there for getting the service, because many things are now online. So when we look at this, what happens is, when certain things goes beyond our control, like if I happen to say something, in Coimbatore, actually there is a social service, Shanti Social Service is there, where they provide food for the below poverty line people with a nominal cost. So if you look at their model, they serve nearly 10,000 people every day. So how do they do it? How do they serve? If you look at it, they will have only 3 billing counters, and the seating capacity will be 1,000 in that hall. And the moment you get the bill and go and get the food, you complete your food and go out. That's all. That's how it happens. And when 10,000 people are getting food in a single place, now if all 10,000, whatever way they come, if they stand in a single queue, it will take a lot of time for billing, first of all. What is that? One thing what you think is, okay, starting from standing on the queue, how much time will you take to get the service first, the billing done? After getting the service, then how much time you are going to spend there? Then what time you are going to go out? So if somebody has to stay for 4 hours to get the food, naturally many people may not like it. At the max, they can wait for 20 minutes to get the food. So what they processed initially, the crowd was less. Then when the crowd became more, they were like, okay, the queue is becoming large and large. Okay, we will go for second counter. Very much like in networking, when the server is busy with a lot of jobs to be done, they set up another server for making the process smooth actually. So under what basis they have to go for next server, or in teller machines in banking system, under what condition they have to go for second teller? in some of the banks, you can see that multiple tellers will be there. So how do they decide that, okay, these many people should serve the people in terms of cash crediting or debiting process? So they normally calculate the length of the queue there, how many people are standing in the queue on an average, or otherwise I can say that, okay, in the queue, what is the average time people spend, and they fix some threshold value there. If it crosses that threshold value every time, then we should go for opening the second teller option. Even today, if you go to many colleges and all, like Anna University or big universities and all, during the admission process, that particular branch will have multiple tellers. But normal days, they don't require those many people. They don't want to waste their resource. What they do is, only during certain peak hours, they will have extra tellers for serving the customer. So how do they decide that we should have this extra people or extra server or extra billing machine? All these things comes under the modeling of certain pattern. And if I have to give you a technical word for it, the queuing system is the correct word to formulate the mathematical modeling of those situations. So in that way, I should say that this queuing system became more powerful, and as we are going with multiple connections and multiple networks, we are almost dealing every day with the networks and all. So in that sense, I should say that this queuing model is becoming like our arithmetic operations, where we don't see the application immediately, but it is our part of life. Okay, it is naturally there, but what we see is we don't see that technical terms behind that, but in our mind it says that it is automatic. So if you connect the terminologies what we are studying in queuing system with the normal process, then this study is becoming more interesting, in the sense that you will see that, okay, these many things are relatively there in our part of life. Well, if we say, okay, how do we relate these terminologies? First of all, think that you are going to a bank. So when you get into the bank, your timing of the arrival is more important. Different people may come at different time. So I can say that it is a random variable, because they come, it is not uniform that they will come exactly at this time. So they come at different times. So first thing what I need to see is, what is that we are going to do with respect to arrival of the customer. If you want to note down, you can note down these things, because these words, you are going to use it again and again in your study also. But these are all the natural concepts what we can pick it up initially. So when the customer comes, what is that we are going to do with respect to the arrival of the customer? So something we have to connect it with the arrival of the customer. Okay. The next thing, once he arrives, how long he is going to stay in the bank overall? How long he is going to stay in the bank? So a customer staying in the system will have to be calculated. So customers' waiting time in the system has to be calculated. That is what we call it as. So once customer comes, how long he has to wait? And the customer comes means how long he has to wait in the queue and overall time in the bank. Then the next part is, what is the service rate? So the other side, from the bank side, how they are serving the people. So what is the service rate from the bank? So if I can understand these things, then my queuing model will become so easy. So I am going to the bank. Once I go to the bank, how much time I need to wait. That is called the waiting time. Then how much time I am getting the service. Then together will be called as the system waiting time. So once all these things are calculated, my queuing model is over. So if the length of the queue is becoming more and more, if the service time is also becoming more, then I can decide that, okay, I may need one more person or one more server for my current scenario. So one more person or one more server for the current scenario, that's what we need to think. Well, how does this process goes? Let me start with something what I say. So first thing is mean rate of arrival I need to calculate, and mean service rate. So these two things I need to calculate: mean rate of arrival and mean service rate. I will come back to these things. So one is with respect to arrival, one is with respect to service. And the notations what we use is one as lambda, the other one as mu. One as lambda, the other one as mu. Okay. So lambda is called the mean rate of arrival, and mean service rate will be called as mu. Well, I will anyway visit these things again and again. And whenever there is only one server, we call the utilization of the server as lambda by mu. Lambda by mu will be called as the utilization of the server. And also it is called the probability that the server is busy or the probability that someone is being served. So this factor will be called as rho. So what we do is, many a times we will give solutions in terms of this rho. That is nothing but mean rate of arrival divided by mean service rate. So we try to give the solution in terms of rho, and depending on the value of rho and other details, we can decide the situation, whether we may need one more server or multiple servers or what is that we can do it. Well, now we are going to tell that the number of servers as C or K, and the related probability will be called as Pn. Pn is nothing but probability that there are n customers in the system. And the terminologies, as I mentioned, these are all the terminologies we will be using. So mean number of customers in the system. So that means average number of customers in the system, and average number of customers in the queue, and mean wait time in the system, and mean wait time in the queue. So I will be talking about only these terminologies for next half an hour. I will be just talking about this. Let us see what are all this. Okay, so how do I start my problem here? It actually starts with this particular diagram. Say, what is this diagram means? Say, suppose I am entering into the system. So lambda naught is the arrival rate, first of all. So I am here, and I have to go through multiple stages to come out of the system. In gaming pattern, you can see. So level 1, level 2, level 3, and also on, you can see something like that. Or otherwise, if you happen to go to something like, I don't know how many of you went to Isha Yoga and all. If you go to Isha Yoga, you have to go to a particular place first. Then again, from there, you have to move to the next place and so on. So the system is like people will be moving from one place to the other place with some kind of idle time in each and every place. That's how they control the queue there. Similarly, what we can say is that, okay, from one state to the other state, the arrival rate is lambda naught. So these 0, 1, 2, n minus 1, n plus 1 are all called states actually. So suppose if I want to go to first state and come out of that, then what is that I can do? The arrival rate is lambda naught. So the service rate is mu 1. So I will come out from here. Suppose if I go to two stage process, what I do is first thing is arrival rate is lambda naught to reach 1. And from 1, I can go to 2 with the arrival rate lambda 1. With the arrival rate lambda 1. And when 2 serves a person, the service rate is lambda mu 2, so that he will come back to the state 1. And once he gets the service here, then the corresponding mu 1 will take him back to the 0th state. So this is called the Poisson queue's transition diagram. That means one place to the other place, we are moving with the arrival rate and service rate. Now, if I see that, say suppose I am actually fixing my nth stage. If I say that this is where I am now. This is where I am now. Expected rate of flow into state N. So what are the ways I can get into the state N is, from here I can use lambda N minus 1 to reach here. With the corresponding probability, I can call it as Pn minus 1. Remember that Pn is nothing but probability that there are n customers in the system. So there are n customers already there in the system. So which means that I am coming from n minus 1 state to nth state with the arrival rate as lambda n minus 1. So if you look at n minus 1 state, already n minus 1 people will be there. The corresponding probability is Pn minus 1. So n minus 1 state length, n state porathukku, if I have to calculate it, I see that lambda n minus 1 into Pn minus 1 is the corresponding rate of flow into state n from n minus 1 state. Similarly, idu vandu oru vazhi, innoru vazhi enna, if I look at the other option to get into state n, I see that I can go from here to here. I can go from here to here. That means from n plus 1th state, I can get into nth state with the service rate as mu n plus 1, and the corresponding probability rate for n plus 1 customers is p n plus 1. So by enna agudna, expected rate of flow into state n is lambda n minus 1 into p n minus 1 plus mu n plus 1 into p n plus 1. Mu n plus 1 into p n plus 1. So this is becoming my expected rate of flow into state n. Now, nth state lende ethana per veliye poranga, what is the expected rate of flow out of state n? Flow out of state n nu paathomna, from nth state, this is one outflow to n plus 1th state. Nth state la irukkumbodhu probability enna? Pn actually. So that will become lambda n into Pn plus one more outflow is with the service rate as mu n. Appo enna aagumna? Mu n into Pn. So expected rate of flow out of state n will become lambda n plus mu n into Pn. So what happens is, one side there are inflows, the other side there are outflows. Appo enna aagumna? More inflows vandhalum prachana, more outflows irundhalum prachana. So what we need to guarantee is that, okay, the system must be stable somewhere. Stability of the system. In a stability of the system, we can talk about our queuing model, which will work perfectly. So what we can do is, expected rate of flow into state n is this, expected rate of flow out of state n is this. So the steady state can be calculated with the name called balance equation. Appo flow into state n must be equal to expected rate of flow out of state n. So appo rendai equate pannena, what I get is lambda n minus 1 into pn minus 1 plus mu n plus 1 into pn plus 1 equal to lambda n plus mu n into pn. So this will be called as the balance equation. So once this is satisfied, I can guarantee the stability of the system. I can guarantee the stability of the system. Okay. Now the next thing is, what else we can study with that? So with n equal to 0, from the initial state, only lambda naught is the outflow, mu 1 is the inflow. So when n equal to 0, we can see that lambda naught mu p naught equal to mu 1 p 1. So that my p 1 is becoming lambda naught by mu 1 into p naught. At the n equal to 2, I can see that my p 2 is going to be multiplication of lambdas divided by multiplication of mu's multiplied by p naught. Oh, இது வந்து ஜெனரலைஸ் பண்ணும்போது that becomes so easy. So Pn will become multiplication of all lambdas to the previous states, and denominator becomes all mu's with the corresponding service rates multiplied by p naught. And we all know that when we talk about the probability, summation of Pn must be equal to 1. So பேலன்ஸ் ஈக்குவேஷன்ல நம்ம என்ன நமக்கு என்ன கிடைக்குதுன்னா, பி ஒன் இஸ் இன் டர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் பி நாட், பி டூ இஸ் இன் டர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் பி நாட், அண்ட் பி என் இஸ் இன் டர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் பி நாட், அண்ட் சம்மேஷன் ஆஃப் பி என் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 1. ஸோ சம் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் வி குட் கெட். அப்போ வாட் இஸ் தட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டூ வித் திஸ் பி நாட் அண்ட் பி என் அண்ட் ஆல் தோஸ்? அதுக்கு முன்னால வாட் வி நீட் டு நோ இஸ் வாட் இஸ் தி standard representation of a queuing model. So first of all, I need to talk about the arrival process. Next thing is I need to talk about the service time. Third thing, I need to talk about the number of servers. Then fourth thing, I need to talk about whether my queuing model is going to be a finite queue or an infinite queue. So the corresponding representation of a queuing model will become m by m by 1 by k, or we can say that m by m by 1 for a single server queue model, and m by g by 1. G means it's a general. So m means my arrival rate is exponential, service rate is exponential, this is number of servers, and this represents whether it is a finite queue or infinite queue. So there are k customers in the queue. So this represents whether it is a finite queue or infinite queue. So this labeling will decide what kind of queues I am dealing with. So in your question or in your problem, they simply say that it is going to be m by m by 1 process, which means that your arrival rate is exponential, service rate is exponential, and it is a single server queue model. If they say instead of 1, if they say n, they are saying that it is a n server model. So in single words, they define what kind of modeling they are following in their networking system. And they will specify the number of servers, and they will also specify, is there a limitation of the number of jobs to be served in a particular server? And the limitations are enna solrana, whether it is a finite queue or infinite queue. So how do we manage all this? Even in parking lot, in malls, big malls, if you see, they follow a queuing model. They can only occupy finite number of cars in the system. So which means that they are following a finite queue model. So if it exceeds every time, then they may need to expand their parking lot, or they have to expand their mall to the adjacent place. And in railways also, you can see the parking lot system, and in the railway track itself, it's a queuing process only, because they have to process the train timings according to the requirement, and they have to optimize it. So this m by n by 1 queues, even there is only one server, if I say that the customer arrival time is lambda for each and every state, then and the service time is mu at every state, then I can say that my model is like m by m by 1q. m by m by 1q means arrival rate is exponential, service rate is exponential, and only one server there. So this is called m by m by 1 model. And many a times when you deal with this arrival rate, they fix the arrival rate as lambda for all states. That means one customer irundalum arrival rate they maintain it as lambda, rendu customer irundalum arrival rate as lambda, ethana customer bank la irundalume they take the arrival rate as lambda. Sometimes they may, this lambda may vary in the rare scenarios, but many a times this arrival rate will become uniform no matter how many customers are there already in the system. So this arrival rate they fixed it as lambda, and service rate again mu, that is also almost it's uniform. So one customer irundalume bank is going to take the same time, rendu customer irundalum they are going to take the same time for serving people, ethana customer irundalume they are going to take the same time for serving the people. So that service rate we call it as mu. Appo enna agumna, my rho will become lambda by mu, my rho will become lambda by mu, and this balance equation la paathomna, in the product term, this product term will become pn will become lambda n divided by mu to the power n into p naught. So this is going to be rho to the power n into p naught. If you see, p1 will become rho into p naught, p2 will become rho square p naught, and so on. My pj will become rho to the power j into p naught. And we also know that our summation of pn equal to 1. Appo inge vande, if I take the summation over all p's here, then 1 equal to p naught into 1 plus rho square. Yeah, series expansion kadagidinga. So my series expansion is coming into picture. Then automatically my p naught will become, my p naught will become 1 minus rho, and pj will become rho to the power j into 1 minus rho. What is the meaning? If I just look at it, what it represents? This formula gives me an enormous energy to calculate all the probabilities. Normally, toughest task in probability problem is calculating the pns, how to get pns. ana inge vandu pathinga, this simple 1 minus rho gives you p naught, and p1 will be defined as rho into 1 minus rho, p2, p3, p4, pj, every probability can be calculated with this simple server utilization factor, that is rho equal to lambda by mu. Vechikitte I can calculate all the probability. So my job is so simple if I compare this with my probability theory. Queuing model epayume, if you look at it, problem will be large, perusa irukum, but solution will be one line. All you need is understand the problem correctly. You understand the problem, then you see what is the arrival rate and what is the service rate and the number of servers in the model. If you understand these three concepts clearly, any queuing model can be answered quickly. All are single line answers. We don't need to think too much and we don't need to derive too much. So if you look at it, my p naught is 1 minus rho, pj is rho to the power j into 1 minus rho, where rho is nothing but lambda by mu. So simple ah mudichu poirum. Ippo nama, if I go back to my system, so as I said, we are going to talk about four things. The average number of customers in the system denoted by L, then average number of customers in the queue denoted by LQ, W mean wait time in the system, WQ mean wait time in the queue. For all these we are going to rely on probability theory. Probability theory la expectation eppadi kandupidipom, xi into pi. So what we are going to do is we are going to apply the same formula here. J into pj, n into pn, summation of j into pj is nothing but expected number of entities in the system. So this is nothing but the expectation formula from probability. Expectation formula from probability, summation of j into p of j entities in this system. Idu vandu p of j is nothing but pn, adha we already know. So here we are denoting it as Pj. So summation of j from 0 to infinity j into Pj. When we have this j into Pj, we already know that Pj is nothing but rho to the power j into 1 minus rho. Just replace it with the rho to the power j into 1 minus rho. J involved term thavara matha ella veli eduthomna, this will become 1 minus rho into rho. If I evaluate it, finally I can say that this is going to be equal to lambda by mu minus lambda. Again, ingeyum pathina sam formula is becoming so simple. If you know the arrival rate, if you know the service rate, you can immediately say the expected number of people in the system. So L equal to lambda by mu minus lambda. So the formula becomes so simple. So the total number of people or the average number of people in the system is going to be lambda by mu minus lambda. Now, இதிலேருந்து மற்றதெல்லாம் எப்படி கண்டுபிடிக்கிறது? So one may ask whether we have to derive the formulas for everything. So if somebody asked me that, you can immediately say that you don't need to derive it. There is something called Little's formula, which will help us to understand that. So what is that Little's formula? We will just So the first thing is one is the expected number of people in the system. The other is expected number of people in the queue. So if I want to calculate the expected number of people in the queue, we already took one person in the service, so remaining j minus 1 will be there in the queue. So if our queuing model irukna, so think that this is your queuing model and this is the server. So one person is getting service, so remaining j minus 1 there will be there in the queue every time. Appo idoda average kandupidikina, this will be equal to j minus 1 into probability of j entities in the system. So automatically this becomes j minus 1 into Pj. So if I simplify that once again, the expected number of entities in the queue is lambda square by mu into mu minus lambda. So that is becoming my LQ, the expected number of entities in the queue. So one is lambda by mu minus lambda is nothing but the number of people in the system, the expected number of people in the queue is lambda square by mu into mu minus lambda. So which again, the formula doesn't require the corresponding probabilities and all. It just gives us the value with respect to lambda and mu. So the arrival rate and service rate itself will give me the corresponding LQ value. Okay, and once I know my L and LQ, it is easy to calculate my W and WQ. What is W and what is WQ? So the average waiting time in the system will be called as W. Average waiting time in the queue will be called as WQ. So this can be arrived using Little's formula. So for anything in the system and the queue, the relation is that the expected number in the system will be equal to lambda times the expected people in the queue. Similarly, expected number of people waiting in the system. Similarly, LQ will be equal to lambda into WQ. So what I can see is that W will be equal to L by lambda, or simply I can say that 1 upon mu minus lambda. So which is again gives me the answer without calculating the probabilities and all, if I know the arrival rate and service rate. So to summarize all this, we can see that my rho is lambda by mu and p naught is 1 minus rho. Probability of n number of people in the system is rho to the power n into 1 minus rho, and the number of people waiting in the system is 1 by mu minus lambda. and the number of people, expected number of people in the system is L equal to lambda by mu minus lambda. And the waiting time in the queue is nothing but lambda by mu into mu minus lambda. And number of people in the queue, expected number of people in the queue is lambda square by mu into mu minus lambda. This is the overall summary for a single server queue model. And also, there is no restriction on queue size. Nowhere we are talking about the size of the queue here. So I am assuming that the queue can be of infinite size. So whenever some people come, they can just join the queue and keep moving in the queue and get the service and go out. So when there is no restriction about the queue size in your problem with a single server, immediately you can answer all the questions with respect to this. So you can immediately say that your utilization factor is rho equal to lambda by mu. So this is called your utilization factor, and the corresponding n number of people, probability of n number of people in the system is Pn, and your W, L, WQ, LQ, so all these things can be answered easily. Hope I am going slow and I am making you understanding the concept clearly with the simple formulas. Because as it is going on as a webinar, I don't want to rush up, as well as I cannot get the feedback from you to clarify the doubts. So I am going little slow and trying to make you understand how simple the queuing model is. So depending on the nature of the problem you are solving, you can relate these terminologies there and immediately answer all these questions. And depending on the answer, one can decide whether they have to go for multi-server model or they can stick with a single server model. Okay. Now, this is the simplest way of handling a queue. The next question is, what happens if I fix my size of the queue? Suppose if I have a closed hall, I cannot accommodate more than certain number of people. So I have to restrict my size of the queue. So when I want to restrict the size of the queue, so I will introduce the terminology like system size. If I consider that as K, so I can introduce K as one of the factor in my problem. I still deal with the arrival rate and service rate as lambda and mu, and my server is single server model. I am going to serve like first come first serve basis, and my size of the queue is finite. So all these things I can first think. And the notation what we are going to use is m by m by 1 by k. This is called your finite queue model. And once again, I can rely on my balance equation for getting the relationship between rho and p. But here, because my size is finite, a modification in my formula will take place where my p naught is not anymore 1 minus rho. I will have this extra denominator factor also. And Pn also will have this extra denominator factor. This is the extra term when we deal with a finite queue. So once we know this, then the corresponding formulas will take a little change. My W will be, I know that lambda W equal to L. Now my W will be L by lambda into 1 minus Pc, and WQ will be LQ by lambda into 1 minus Pc, where the representation is that L is equal to LQ plus LB. So what is this LB? So if you see this, when you have a server here, single server model, and this is the length of the queue, the moment you see that the queue is full, people will be leaving this queue. So that leaving rate or the rate of not entering the system, you call it as lambda b, and those who are entering into the system, you call it as rate of entering the system. So my lambda is split into two factors, one as lambda e and one as lambda b. So the one related to lambda b is called the lb here. The remaining terminologies are same. Lambda e, mu, p naught, all those things are. So here lambda will be called as effective arrival rate. Remember that when the q is finite, then only you need to talk about this effective arrival rate, or otherwise there will be only one lambda. Okay, so lambda e is nothing but the effective arrival rate, which can be calculated like lambda into 1 minus pk. So how many people can get into the system, or probability of system is not full. So lambda e can be calculated as lambda into 1 minus pk. And lambda b is nothing but lambda into, there are k people in the system, which means that lambda into pk, where these formulas for pks are already discussed here. Pn is this. So once you have these formulas, I can again go back to my expected number of people in the system, and all the formulas like utilization of the server and average customers in the queue and average waiting time and average time spent in the queue, and all these factors will turn out to be a little modification with the original formula. So once again, what I want to say is that when you read the problem, first you categorize that as, are you dealing with finite queue or infinite queue? If it is infinite queue, what is the arrival rate and service rate? Based on these two factors, you can answer all the questions. Suppose if it is a finite queue, then you see what is your effective rate of arrival, which means that how many people may leave the queue. So once you calculate your lambda e, rest of the things can be calculated quite easily. Okay, some of the problems, what I want to share with you is that from the given problem, it is saying that the inter arrival time is exponentially distributed with a mean of 10 minutes. So mean of 10 minutes, and the service time is also exponentially distributed with a mean of 8. Find the mean wait time in the queue, mean number in the queue, the mean wait time in the system, and all these things. So all I want is, what is my lambda, what is my mu? Once I know that, I can answer with the formulas LQ, WQ, WL, 1 minus rho. All are simple calculations now. Okay. And similarly, I can say that I can talk about finite people in the system. So N cars in the system. Then once again, when you look at the formula, it may look very lengthy. But what you need to do is you need to just identify what is your lambda and p and answer the questions. Anyway, I'm not going to bore you with all these problems. I'm just giving you an idea of how these terminologies are useful in your queuing model. And what you need to concentrate is when you get the problem, check whether what is your lambda and mu, and most of the problems you can answer with that. And I think with that, let me stop my presentation. And once again, I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to give you a glimpse of what is a queuing model and how do we arrive at certain solutions for this. Thank you all for giving me this opportunity. Over to you there. Thank you so much. Hello. Can you hear? Yeah. Yes.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Any questions from that side, or anybody having any questions, or we can wind up the session.
Sir, actually the students are sitting in an auditorium with a single system. As virtually we are sitting over here, So anyway, I will. So that's because if it is in online offline, then we can have interaction. But anyway, I will. Thank you. Anyway, I'll inform the students to contact Professor Ayyambale sir and as well as Venkatesan sir to give over the comments as well as the questions, so that when you are free, you can make it over the information through the mail or an chat. You can give it, sir.
Sure, sir. No issues. Yeah.
So thank you for your valuable information related to the queuing model, and I make my special thanks and personal thanks to Professor Ayyambale sir, who know about for the past 15 years in this institute.
Thank you.
So we have a good binding other than
thank you
as a relationship. We have a interdisciplinary is very important, especially in the growth of research as well as in the setup. So and I just want to make some kind of information related to Professor Ayyambale is having a good kind of knowledge in latex, I think so. So if he given any kind of presentation related to it, so that it will be useful for our computer science faculties also. So sir, you can make any time frame for that. Maybe we can use that knowledge.
Yes, sir. So,
thank you. And I take this opportunity to make our Professor Ayyambale sir to make a vote of thanks. Please, sir.
Okay, thank you. It is my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, on behalf of the CAC department and the coordinators, extend a very hearty vote of thanks to the honorable delegates who blessed us with his presence and took out valuable time of his busy schedule. I must mention our deep sense appreciation for Dr. S. Harigaran for this work. Thank you, sir. I wish to express my gratitude to our reputed vice chairman, esteemed registrar, honorable principal, for providing encouragement and constant support. Extending gratitude to head of the department of CAC department for giving us an opportunity to organize this event. I congratulate to all the active participants for this constant attention in this event. Thank you very much.
Sir, Professor Harigaran sir, any words from your side actually?
Thanks to all of you first of all for listening, and also I would like to thank the CAC department to make this initiative to have this workshop done. And I am sure if this is going to be with some kind of with the real time problem and all, it will be more useful to the students. But as we are dealing with the online mode, we can only talk few more things we need to model it and do, and we may require time also to do all those things with the stipulated time of 1 hour. I just want to share my knowledge of what is that in queuing model. And many a times when we talk about the queuing model with the computer science or the ECE people there, sometimes what they feel is that is actually quite complicated one. But I would like to share my knowledge that it's not a complicated one. It is only the understanding of the problem that makes the things so easy for us. That's what I want to say. And once again, thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir.
So thanks all the students on your presentations to be made, and also we have some of the faculties from outside has been joined over here. Sweta ma'am and as well as Mr. Mohan Raj, I think so, they have been joined from out of the institute. So I am also thanks for their presence on behalf of our today's chief guest, Dr. Harigaran sir, and our Dr. Ayyambale sir. So thank you for all to make it this to be and make the students to be take it in a right path. So because actually we plan to take it by every faculties to take an intention, especially on a weekend, to concentrate about and any kind of an specified topics related to the syllabus as well as to the curriculum, so that the students can able to know about one step to be forwarded with the experts, that what Ayyambale sir has been identified and given a right person at the right time. So I am thanks to Professor Ayyambale sir, and as well as my special thanks to Harigaran sir. Maybe in future we can have some more workshops and any other related to the queuing models. And so on behalf of the institution as well as on behalf of Department of Computer Science sir, I request you to have your valuable support in future also, sir. Please, sir.
Yeah, sure, sir.
Yeah.